All right, Shalom, Yasha Allah, back with another GMS on the go. I'm Brother Nakum. I'm with the Raleigh, North Carolina camp. Before I go any further, I'd like to give all honor, all glory, and all praises to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah, Ba'ashem, Rakakudash. Next up, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone from teaching us this truth according to the Bible, who rule well. And a double Shalom to all the Sisiakim throughout the four corners of the earth, pushing the truth in righteousness and sincerity to the best of your ability. And I was able to get up today through the spirit and power of Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah. Yahweh, that's who the word Iklan calls God, which his name means he is or he exists. And Yahweh Shah being the only begotten Son, that's who the word they call Jesus, which his name means he saves or he delivers. And I'm just going to get into a Lord willing, edifying lesson today on the Lord kills. I'm going to say that again. I'm going to get into a Lord willing, edifying lesson today on the Lord kills. So without further ado, I'm going to dive into it, grab my first precept, and Lord willing, the elect of the nation of Israel, so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans, are edified. All right. This is 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 6. The Lord, Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah, who the world ignorantly calls God and Jesus, killeth. And that's right. So Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah, the God of the Bible, they're the ones doing all the killing upon the face of the earth. They're the ones putting you people to death upon the face of the earth. Not some devil under the ground with horns on his head and a pitchfork. Not these false gods who are no gods, like Allah, Buddha, the Hindu god of Sheba, Santa Maria, Baphomet, Jesus Christ, you know, that two-thirds of the nation of Israel of our people be worshiping. Not Esau, the so-called white man, or any of these other nations. It's Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah, again, the God of the Bible, that's doing all the killing upon the face of the earth. You see, they're the ones bringing judgment upon you people, putting you to death by the way of these house fires, by the way of these car crashes and plane crashes, by the way of these police shootings and massacre shootings, by the way, you know, these heart attacks, stroke, aneurysms, by the way, these tornadoes, tsunamis, floods, earthquakes, these powerful storms, you name it. It's Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah, the God of the Bible, that's doing these things. You see? They're the ones killing your people upon the face of the earth. All credit goes to them. Read it from the top again. This is 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 6. The Lord, Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah, killeth and maketh alive. He bringeth down to the grave and bringeth up. That's right. So not only does Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah kill and make alive, but they also bring down to the grave, meaning they'll bring you down to hell, to a lower state. And at the same time, they'll also bring you up from that lower state. You see, Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah has power to do all these things. They're in control of all these things. But the point of this lesson is, Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah, they're the ones doing all the killing upon the face of the earth. They're the reason why you people upon the face of the earth are dying and being put to death. So I'm going to grab my next precept, and again, Lord willing, the elect of the nation of Israel, so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans, are edified. Alright, this is Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 39. See now that I, even I, am he, and there is no God with me. That's right. So Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah, they are the one and only living true power. The only power that's been from the beginning and the only power that's going to be to the end. All these false gods who are no gods that I named earlier, like Allah, Buddha, Santa Maria, the Hindu god of Sheba, Jesus Christ, Baphomet, they're not with Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah in the heavens, you know, giving them orders, telling them what to do. Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah, they stand alone. They give their own orders to their own selves. They tell their own selves what to do. You see, there's no power with Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah. It reads on, I kill. There it is again. So Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah, they're the ones doing all the killing upon the face of the earth. The evil, the bad times that we're fast approaching, that we're coming into, Yahweh Ba'ashem Al Shah is going to have it to a what? He's going to bring these evils upon two-thirds of you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans, and especially you heathen nations. You see? They're going to have it to where what? You people are going to go through the famine of food and thirst. You're going to go through the race riots. You're going to go through martial law, Tifa Wild Beast, which are these animals, Leviathan, Bigfoot, the 200 million ICBM missiles, which will destroy America, the chariots with the word Igling calls UFOs, with the laser beam fire coming down from the bottom of it. You see, and so forth and so on. Yeah, how about Shema Shada got a Bible? They're going to have it to where you people are going to go through these things. And you're going to be put to death by these things. By them. You see, because what? They're the ones doing all the killing upon the face of the earth. Again, all credit goes to them. Read that from the top again. This is Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 39. See now that I, even I, am he. And there is no God with me. I kill and I make alive. I wound and I heal. There it is. Salakia, there it is again. So the God of the Bible, not only do they kill and make alive, but they also wound and they heal. It reads on. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand. That's right. So when Yahweh Shemashah got that eyeset on you, and they want to take you out, they want to kill you, put you to death, wound you. Can't nobody save you. Can't nobody help you. Can't nobody deliver you out of their hands. And as Hebrews 10 and 31 says, it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living power, Yahweh Shemashah, because can't nobody deliver you out of their hands. You see? So again, Yahweh Shemashah, the God of the Bible, they're the ones doing all the killing upon the face of the earth. They're the ones putting you people to death upon the face of the earth. Alright, this is Psalms chapter 68, verse 20. He that is our God is the God of salvation. That's right. And you so-called Negroes, Latino Americans, who was your God? Who was your power? Yahweh Shemal Shah. Yahweh being the Heavenly Father, which his name means he is or he exists. And Yahweh Shah being the only begotten Son, which his name means he saves, he delivers. And not only are they our power, but they're the power of our salvation. They will be the reason why the elected nation of Israel, first and foremost on this side, will get saved up out of this captivity from being enslaved under Esau, the so-called white man, to eventually all Israel be saved in the kingdom. You see? So Yahweh Shemashah, they're our power, and they're the power of our salvation. They're going to be the reason why we get saved. It reads on. And unto Yahweh Shemashah belong the issues from death. That's right. So the issues from death, of you people dying on the face of the earth, it belongs to Yahweh Shemashah. You see? Yahweh Shemashah is in control of you people being put to death upon the face of the earth. You see? Because they know the exact year. They know the exact month. They know the exact day. They know the exact hour, the exact minute, the exact second on when you're going to be put to death. They know the exact way on how you're going to be put to death. Why? Because the issues of death belongs unto Yahweh Shemashah. They're the ones putting you people to death upon the face of the earth. They're the ones doing all the killing upon the face of the earth. So again, all credit goes to Yahweh Shemashah, the God of the Bible. So I'm going to grab one more precept, and then I'm going to close out. Alright, this is Job chapter 4 verse 7. Remember, I pray thee, whoever perish being innocent. That's right. And that word perish means to die. So all these people who are perishing from off the face of the earth, who are being put to death by the hands of the God of the Bible, Yahweh Shemashah, when it's not because they're innocent, it's because they're being wicked. You know, 2/3 of you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans, and especially heathen nations, but mainly getting on 2/3 of you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans. You see, y'all were given the right ways to know how to conduct yourself, to know how to carry yourself upon the face of the earth. But yet you want to go and act like these wicked heathen nations, and you know, and transgression go against Yahweh Shemashah word. So therefore, y'all are leaving Yahweh Shemashah, the God of the Bible, no choice but to put you to death. with these other wicked heathen nations, but to make you perish from off the face of the earth, right along with these other wicked heathen nations. You see? It reads on. Or where were the righteous cut off? And the righteous was never cut off. The ones who were doing the will of Yah Bashi Mashah, they was never cut off. So, Yah Bashi Mashah, the God of the Bible, they're the ones making you people perish from off the face of the earth, from being wicked. They're the ones putting you people to death. They're the ones doing the killing upon the face of the earth. You see? So that's my lesson. Lord willing, the elect of the nation of Israel, so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans, were edified. Before I go any further, I'd like to give all honor, all glory, and all praises to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, and Karkwadash. Next up, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone for teaching us this truth according to the Bible and rule well. And the double shalom to all the Sisiakim throughout the four corners of the earth, pushing this truth and righteousness and sincerity to the best of ability. Till next time, shalom, Kwam Yasha Allah.